Community of the Dunkelgrün Podcast. My name is Anna and today is a lovely spring Sunday here in Zurich in Switzerland where I'm coming to you from. Behind me is my cat Lila. She is very cozy there, sleeping. I'm not sure if she's going to make an appearance, but maybe. So welcome to this episode. I'm very happy that you are here and I have a very exciting and different program than usual today. We will start with some knitting projects, one finished project and one work in progress, and then I'm going to take you on a little trip because yesterday my boyfriend and I did a trip to the canton of Bern here in Switzerland where we visited a fiber farm. Actually, it's very hard to describe this place in one word because it's a yarn shop, a carding facility, a farm, there was a sheep show happening there, and it is a fantastic place and we created a lot of wonderful memories there yesterday, and I took a little bit of footage and want to share that with you. And we are also going to talk a little bit about a rare sheep breed here in Switzerland which was exposed there yesterday at this farm. Also, we have had the wonderful knit-along in our Ravelry group, which is the Dunkelgrün Ravelry group on the Ravelry Groups tab, and we had a knit-along where people were encouraged to dye their own yarn for their projects. And this knit-along was going on for quite a long time, since last year's September, so for more than 6 months now. And I have decided to draw some winners, but I would like to let the call still keep running because I really enjoy this knit along and I really enjoy this thread, and so many people are joining in with questions about dyeing, and it's just a very nice place to be and it's very inspirational. So the thread will stay open and I will do another giveaway. I think I said in June. I wrote it in the thread. I forgot the date that I said. I think I will, in the middle of summer somewhere, I will do another giveaway for this cowl. But for now, we have I have chosen three winners with the help of random.org. And these three winners and the prizes that they're going to win are going to be towards the, I think I should throw in this direction, towards the end of the episode. So if you participated in the cowl, please stick around. And also, we are going to have a giveaway to celebrate the 20th episode, because yay, it's episode 20 today. And also this giveaway I am going to announce in the very end of the episode. So let's get started with finished projects. I have a finished project for you today, and if you are following me on Instagram, where I am at dunkelgrün with an underline, by the way. If you follow me there, you have already seen it, because it's my Edinburgh Yarn Festival shawl. This shawl is a very special thing to me because I cast it on the way to the Edinburgh Yarn Festival, and I knit it out of my own handspun yarn. And the fiber that I used for it is the Malabrigo Noob in the colorway Bothion, and this is a non-superwash fiber. And I have to add a huge correction to what I have said in the last episode. I said this was the only product by Malabrigo that is non-superwash, and that is absolutely wrong. Malabrigo has superwash bases, which I think are the, I don't remember which ones exactly, Rios for sure is superwash, Arroyo is superwash, the others I am not so sure, but they have a lot of yarns, like I think the Merino Worsted, for example, which are not superwash, and also the Malabrigo Lace is not superwash. And it's best to check out their website, and they have a page for each base, and then if you scroll down a little bit below the colorways, it will tell you if this base can be machine washed or if it is better washed by hand. And if it says washed by hand, then it's non-superwash. So that's how you can find out. And there's actually quite a lot of them, and I think that's a nice opportunity because many of us, or many of you, love the colors of Malabrigo because they are very interesting and they have also some speckled stuff going on. So I think that is a really cool opportunity to get some colorful and interesting non-superwash yarn. of course, there's also other places. I just wanted to mention that. So back to my shawl from this little intermezzo. I really love it. I knit a basic triangle. I didn't use a pattern. I just cast on here at the top, and then I did some increases in the center and at the edges, and I created a basic triangle. I also did two short row edges, which you probably cannot even tell if you look at it now. And yeah, the yarn was about fingering weight. I can maybe show you a bit more close up how the stitch definition is, because I am really happy with my handspun yarn. I think it turned out really lovely and even. And yes, there are also some garter stitch sections and some garter stitch ridges. And at the border, I did some seed stitch. You cannot see that so well because it's quite irregular, this border, from the color, I mean, the color distribution. So you cannot really see the seed stitch so well, but it still looks like a nice border. And also, I did some tassels. This was the first time that I added tassels to a project, and I really like them. They are super cool. And I also really like the focus of my camera. If you're curious how I do that with the focus, I have a Canon camera, and I choose the selected area focus, and I put the selected area to right here in the middle. So if you see, my hand now is going to be in focus, and anything that I put here into the middle is going to go into focus. So I don't have any face recognition or anything on. I just say whatever is in this area is going to be in focus. And yes, I am usually in this area because I'm sitting in the center of the screen. Just a little tip for other podcasters who maybe have problems with the focus of their cameras. And I am very good today at getting off topic. We are talking about this shawl. And yeah, I really like it. It's very nice and light because it is a fingering weight yarn, and I like how the color appears as a neutral color from a bit more far away, and how those tassels, now I need to get up a little bit, how those tassels are just getting, yeah, making a nice little extra to this shawl. I think it's really pretty. Yeah, so I'm very happy with that, and I think I'm gonna keep it on because I'm a little chilly right now. So the next project that I'm going to show you, you have not seen yet on the podcast. It is a work in progress that I have cast on right after I have finished this shawl. And it was actually an idea that I had in mind since I came back from EYF. I don't know what it was. It must have been something that I have seen there, but I had the idea for a colorwork sweater. And so I sat down and I drew a chart and I did some calculations. I used the Vogue knitting book. There is a sweater design sheet in the Vogue, the Ultimate Knitting Book, I think it's called. And I used that sweater design sheet to help a little bit with the calculations and took my measurements. And so now I have cast on, and that's how it looks so far. You cannot see so much yet. Well, it's still pretty good progress for the fact that I have only knit on it for a week now. I think I cast it on last weekend. And you can see that I'm using this kind of Norwegian star, the Selbu star, and also some of those little dots. And yeah, that's how far I am now. And I really enjoyed calculating this sweater. So I'm not going to talk too much about it yet, how I'm going to do it. I think I will talk about it as I am doing it, because I might also still modify it. But I did the calculations of my armhole and the crossback and my bust and everything, and how many stitches to decrease and everything to make the armhole shaping. That was really a lot of fun. I have done that just a little bit. I have just altered other patterns so far to fit me or to suit a different yarn weight, but I have not really done it from scratch, so that was really a lot of fun. And I don't know, maybe I will write a pattern for this sweater. I don't know yet. I think still that it would be a bit difficult for me to estimate other sizes, but then there are also tables for standard sizes, and I might be able to just calculate each size because it was so much fun to do it. I'm a bit of a nerd here. But yeah, this is how it looks and I couldn't be happier with it. I think it's going to turn out just the way I imagined it, at least so far. And yes, it is bottom up. This is the hem here. It is a 2x2 rib. And then I am just doing this color work motif. And of course, I should talk about the yarn because this is really special yarn. And actually already we can almost call it deep stash already because I had it in my stash since more than a year or for more than a year. This is Lanarara yarn, and this is rare Swiss wool, which is produced 100% here in Switzerland. It contains wool from rare Swiss sheep breeds, the Sasermutten, Spiegelschaf, Bündner Oberländerschaf, and Engadiner Schaf. And 33% or one third of mulesing free merino wool. So these Swiss sheep breeds are known to be a bit scratchy and not so next to skin soft, so that they mixed the Swiss wool with some soft organic merino wool, and that's the result. And this yarn is available online in the yarn shop of Neustadtgasse, which is in Winterthur, and I have never been there. I really want to go there, and I think I will go there in the near future. Probably still before summer. And yeah, it's a little shop that has yarn but also other nice household things and crafts, so I really should go and check that shop out. And I love the yarn. I have also the other color here. I have shown you a bit about this yarn already on the podcast because I have some other colors of it also. So this is the blue. This is called Rauchblau in German, which is just stands for smoky blue smoke blue. And so what I have shown you before is this little swatch that I have made in this yarn, and this here is the olive green colorway of that yarn, and I have actually not turned this swatch yet into a project because in the end I got inspired by this color work idea that I had in my mind, so I decided to go with that. And maybe this one will become another sweater or even something else, who knows? Or maybe it's just going to stay my pretty little swatch, who knows? But I really love the yarn. It is nice and toothy and it has a lot of elasticity. I have the feeling while I knit with it, you know, you can feel how the string is really elastic, and when you tension it, it's almost a bit difficult to tension it because it's so elastic. I forgot to mention in the introduction that I also have some spinning to share with you in this episode. I have talked about before that I am spinning a yarn to make the Telia sweater, of which I can put a picture here. It's a design by Jennifer Steingass and another very beautiful yoke design that I decided to spin yarn for. And Nina of Fox and the Sheep is doing the very same thing. She is also spinning yarn to make the sweater. So we are having a little informal knit along between, or spin along at the moment, between the two of us. And actually I wanted to say, if there's anyone else out there who is spinning yarn for the Telia sweater, or we could also say another kind of yoked sweater, let's say a yoked sweater. If you're spinning yarn for a yoked sweater or you would like to do that, maybe let us know. Maybe we can do a little spin and knit along together. So I have some progress in this project because I plied my first skein of yarn and I am extremely proud of it. This is not washed yet. This is now just off the wheel, and usually my yarns, when they just come off the wheel, they are a little bit more irregular because after washing they usually get a bit more, they get the final, homogeneity. But this one is already extremely nice and very regular, and I am actually, yes, I am really proud of it because I think it looks extremely even, and I think it's absolutely the quality to make is better. I'm spinning really slowly, and that's also, I think, why it is so regular, because I'm really taking the time. I'm correcting any little you know, when you're spinning, you can always correct when you have a thicker place or a thinner place. So when I notice that I made a thicker spot or a thinner spot, I'm always stopping and I'm correcting that. And also this is undyed fiber. It is a BFL comb top and I'm splitting the braid and I'm pre-drafting it so that it will be easy to work with it. And yes, yeah, so it's really coming out pretty good. It's a 2-ply and I'm aiming at a DK weight to maybe light worsted weight yarn. It will get a little bit thicker when I wash it because that's what wool usually does. When you spin it, it will be slightly have more, right after spinning it will have slightly more meter rate or yardage and be a bit thinner, and after you wash it, it shrinks a bit and it grows a little bit in diameter. That is just due to the nature of the crimp of the fiber, which kind of pulls together again. It's, you can imagine it like when you have curls and you maybe stress your curls, you brush them or you even use a straightener or something on your curls, and then they get a bit straight or hang out, and if you wash them again and let them dry in air, bing, they are curls again. And the same thing happens also with the wool and with the wool fibers, and that's why after I wash this one it will probably be a little bit more plump than it is now. I'm curious how it's gonna be. And yeah, this is a naturally colored oatmeal, and I'm planning also to spin a little bit of white BFL, and a part of this I'm also going to dye. Well, of course, I have to spin more. This is not enough. This is just a bit more than 100 grams, I think 130 grams or so, and I will have to spin more. I also have a bit more singles. This was just one bobbin full of plying, and I still have more singles that I can ply to make a second ball, but it will not be 100 grams the second ball, so it will be less. But yeah, I like it. I'm very happy with it. And I have talked enough about it now. Yeah, now let's move to our special segment, which is the trip to the Spiegelhandwerk. I have the tote bag of the shop here, which says Schaukarderei in Hutwil. And Schaukarderei is a word that is hard to translate. Basically, a karderei is a place where you card, a carding facility, and Schau means that you can have a look at it. So it's a carding facility where people can walk in and have a look. And also it says the address. It says woolen duvets and pillows for the bed, hand-woven carpets, natural bed systems, spinning wheels, weaving looms, carded wool, knitting wool, articles out of fur and woolen clothing. And that summarizes one part of this place, because the other place is that they are basically a petting zoo. They have a lot of things for children. Children can basically go into the fences and pet baby goats and things like that. And they also have a huge selection of natural cosmetics. They have lanolin, they have any kind of product you can make with lanolin and sheep milk in the cosmetic area, and they have a ton of spinning fibers and pretty much everything that Ashford, the Ashford from New Zealand, Ashford wheels and looms, any product from Ashford they are selling as well, and plant dyes and everything. And they have a little restaurant there as well, which I think is not open every time, but it was really good and we really enjoyed our visit. So the reason why I went there was that there was an exhibition of sheep. It was the spring meeting of the Breeders Association of the Roux du Valais breed, which is the French name, and I think it's also the name that is used in English for the breed. In German, the name is Walliser Landschaft, and this sheep comes from the canton of Valais, or in German Wallis, in Switzerland, which is a very south west part of Switzerland at the border to France, and it's also the very mountainous area where you also have the city of Zermatt or the famous mountain, the Matterhorn. It's a place where many tourists go. I myself have actually only been once to this canton in Switzerland. And yeah, the sheep come originally from there, and they used to be used a lot for their wool and also for the meat. There used to be bread for both. And in the beginning of the 20th century, they have been used less and less, and there have been fewer and fewer of their sheep because nobody was interested in them anymore, and because nobody wanted the wool anymore. And nowadays there is an association which breeds them, and they have managed to bring up the population again. So now there is about 1,000 of these sheep, of these Roux du Valais sheep in Switzerland, which is not such a bad number. Of course it's a small number, but it's quite okay. And they're really taking good care of the breed, I think. So now I will insert a little clip of our trip there, and I hope that you are going to enjoy it. I am going to take you on a little trip to Huttwil in the canton of Bern in Switzerland. Here is this beautiful farm, carding mill and fiber shop called Spiecher Handwerk. This is the place where the wool is received from other farms. Here is the wool washing workshop. And this is Walter. He is a big fan of wool, and his job is washing the raw fleeces. After being washed and dried, the wool is ready to be carded, which happens here. At one end, the wool is fed into the machine. Then it passes the picker. And here it enters the giant drum carder. The carded fleece is finally collected on this last big roll. The carded wool is used to produce insulation, duvets, mattresses, and other products. Some of it is, of course, also sold in the shop on the farm. There is also a second shop, which is probably more suited for the general, not so fiber crazy public. Thank you. Another huge attraction on the farm are, of course, the animals. These are Ratzka sheep, Gotland sheep, Jacob sheep, Skude sheep, and some hungry merinos. On the farm, there are also llamas, alpacas, and camels. And these funny woolly pigs. And also some goats. One of the events that was held at the farm on this day was the spring meeting of the Breeders' Association of the endangered Swiss sheep breed Roux du Valais. The sheep were graded and the most beautiful ones were awarded with prizes. The three criteria for grading were the type, if they look like the breed should look like, some health characteristics, for example if the legs are straight and if they walk healthily, and finally, of course, the wool. The second event taking place on that day was the Alpine Cashmere Day. We got to watch these pretty Swiss cashmere goats being combed. And there was also a cute little baby. So yes, of course, I also bought something at the Spiecher Handwerk place because there were so many great things. It was actually even a bit difficult to choose. And I was really interested in getting some wool from the Roux du Valais sheep. But the breeders themselves, they actually, when I talked to them about the wool, they were like, yeah, we have wool. Of course, all of us have the wool, but yeah, I can give you a list of members. Oh, wait, no, we don't have it here. Oh, you have to talk to this lady back there in black. And she was super busy because they were grading the sheep and everything. And then I was like, yeah, I will contact you via your website because they seem to be not prepared for any people coming and wanting the wool because they did not think that anyone would want the wool. And then in the end she also said to me, but you know, this wool is very scratchy. And then I said, yeah, it's okay, I just want to give it a try if you have some. I don't want to take a whole fleece maybe, but I would like to give it a little try. And then yeah, they were super busy, so I didn't want to disturb them further. I thought I would just maybe later contact them via their website and see if I can get my hands on some wool. But it turned out that in the wonderful huge selection of Spiecher's fiber shop, they had some Roux du Valais and I bought some. This is a carded bat directly made on these carding machines that you have seen in the video and also hand washed by Walter, who you have seen in the video, the hand washer of this place. And yes, it's a lot. And do you think, how much do you guess? Make a guess in your mind how much you think that is. Because I picked it up and then I thought, yeah, that's probably a sweater's quantity. I'm gonna get that. And no, this is, turns out this is just 330 grams. So it is just super airy. There is really a lot of air in this carded fleece and I absolutely love it. And now comes the question, is it scratchy? I don't think it's scratchy. I think this, the term scratchy or the predicate scratchy has been given to this fiber by people who are not used to wool and who don't wear wool, because I think it is, of course it's not a merino, but it is not scratchy. It is pretty fine actually. It is comparable to a Shetland wool. Maybe a bit more, a bit different from the properties. I have also spun up a little sample. I know I have been there only yesterday, but I spun up this sample this morning because I was so curious. And yeah, I did also a 2-ply, and this is about an Aran weight yarn. And it is a little bit inhomogeneous. I also had some places where the single got broken because I didn't put enough twist inside, because every time you use a new breed or new wool type you need to get adjusted a bit to it. And I think it's really nice. I like it. I could have a sweater out of this. Doesn't scratch me. I think I'm gonna get more of that wool. I'm going to tell those people to not throw it away because it's too precious to be thrown away. And those sheep are so cute. Yeah, so this is my experience with Roux du Valais. And I also bought some natural wool that is not dyed, and this has also been produced in the facilities of Spiecher. And this is not a breed specific wool. It just says 100% Swiss wool. And the thickness is actually a sport weight, and it is non-superwash, and it says it is ideal for dyeing, knitting, weaving and felting. So that's all you get about this yarn. And I bought this because I'm going to use it as a prize for our self-dyed knit-along, and this is going to come afterwards. So one of the participants of the self-dyed knit-along is going to win these two skeins to dye them and make something nice for them. And I have to say, this one is softer than the Roux du Valais. It is a really nice quality. Probably it has a lot of Swiss merino in it. We will not know, because it's just all the kinds of white sheep that they find. So we don't know. Another thing that I bought was a mug. I usually don't drink teas and show off mugs on my podcast like many other people do, because I like to focus on other things. But this mug really got my attention. It has sheep wearing sweaters. Aren't these guys the coolest? So I really love them. And just because we already have a mug on the podcast, I am drinking chamomile tea. So. And the company who produces this awesome mug is Deesdutch.com, which is from the Netherlands. So the website is Deesdutch.com. I'm going to link that in the show notes because I think this is a really cool product. I love it. And what else? Did I buy something else? Oh, of course. I bought the giant pot full of lanolin. This is how much lanolin I bought. This is 400 grams. And yes, this is going to last me a very long time. And yes, there's going to be more soaps and more lotions coming up in my future, because now I have to. Now I have so much lanolin. Mmm, it smells so good. Here you go. This is natural lanolin. And I also talked to the owner about the about where the lanolin comes from. And he told me that in Switzerland there is nobody who purifies lanolin, because the big thing with lanolin is that it needs to be purified so that all the pesticides come out of it, because this is not possible really to do on a farm. On a farm you can maybe do some centrifugation, like you would also do with honey, to get rid of the dirt. But there is pesticides inside the lanolin, which comes in through the atmosphere, through the rain. Nobody is protected from it, not even in the most remote places of the world. And these pesticides need to be cleaned out in a chemical process, and this requires a lab. And he said it as if there wouldn't be any labs in Switzerland, the place where we have very famous pharmaceutical companies, but of course none of them are interested in lanolin, because probably it doesn't make enough money. And so in Switzerland there is no way to produce cosmetic grade lanolin, unfortunately. The lanolin here is thrown away. And I was talking to Patricia from Nitography at Edinburgh, and Patricia also said that she tried to find people in Norway who would produce lanolin, or who would gain the lanolin from the wool, and she was not successful so far. And I would assume that it's very similar in Norway. You can probably get some lanolin, but in order to use it for cosmetics you need a purified one. You cannot just use the crude one that you can make yourself on the farm, unfortunately. I mean, you can, but it's just not so healthy with the pesticides and environmental pollutants that can be inside the fat, unfortunately. But still, they have a nice lanolin that comes from Belgium, that's what she told me, and it also comes from good production, so it's not from a large-scale Chinese whatever company, so it is also from a good production. So yes, lanolin. So finally, let's get to our giveaway. I have picked three winners for our self-dyed cowl, and I wanted at this point to thank everybody who has participated for their lovely contributions. I am sorry if I was not always up to date with your posts, because it was sometimes just a lot, but I always enjoyed when I was coming back to the thread. It was such a lovely chatter, and people were so creative and inspiring and helping each other and discussing different dyeing plans and methods and encouraging each other. So thank you all so much for this wonderful experience and for being here. It means really a lot to me. I would love to give a prize to each and everybody, but this is unfortunately out of my capacities. So I'm going to pick three winners right now. And there are going to be more winners with prizes that I have not determined yet, towards the middle of 2018, and then I will use the posts. There will not be another FO thread for then, there will be just a chatter thread, and I will use the posts that have been written between now or the beginning of April and June or July, I don't know yet which date I have set in 2018. So one of our giveaway prizes is this lovely undyed yarn from Abundant Earth Fiber, and this base is called United Tribe, and it is a worsted weight 100% US merino, and this has been donated by Abundant Earth Fiber. So thank you very much for this wonderful donation. On top of that, you will receive a wool tincture, which is also by Abundant Earth Fiber, and this is basically a little dyeing kit which contains a color, so it's a color pack. It contains the acid dye and citric acid, and you can just use that to dye the yarn at home very easily. And just before I forget to mention it, Abundant Earth Fiber has offered a coupon code to all viewers of the Dunkelgrün podcast, and I'm going to include that here in case you're interested in their products. And the winner of this wonderful prize is from the US, and it is post number 26, and that is Ravelry member Gonna Knit. And I am so happy that she won, because this is Paige, and Paige has been so active in this knit along. She has knitted 6 projects out of her own hand dyed yarn, and already before the cowl she has actually always posted what she was dyeing, because she, I think she dyes for each and every project that she knits, she dyes the yarn. And then she just gets some yarn that she has already in her stash, of which she doesn't like the color, and over dyes it, and she dyes with food coloring, and She just achieves the most amazing results with the things she has at home. Let me put it this way. And her yarn looks like professionally indie-dyed yarn, but she uses food coloring and yarn in unloved colors from her stash to make it. So it's really impressive. And I love that Paige has won this, and I am sure that she's going to have fun with it. So congratulations, Paige. Please get in touch with me and send me your address, and I will get this out to you. The next winner, as I have already hinted, is going to win also two skeins of yarn. And these are two skeins of sport weight yarn from the Spücher carding facility in Switzerland. And it's also undyed and for your own dyeing pleasure. And so you also get a pack of wool tinctures from Abundant Earth Fibers to dye these two. And basically each of these packages has enough dye inside to dye 200 grams of yarn, so I think that fits perfectly. And the winner of this prize is also someone I'm very happy that she won, because it's post number 23, and this is Sushi Shu, and that is Laura. And I met Laura also at Edinburgh Yarn Festival, unfortunately only very shortly, because it was extremely busy at the podcasters lounge at the time she came around, and I also had to leave quickly, and I don't know, we couldn't do much more than say hello, even though I would have loved to chat a little bit more with you, Laura. But I love that you have won the prize, because what you have knit is also a truly amazing project. She has knit first a hat for herself, and she has also knit a pair of socks for her grandfather's 90th birthday. And these socks are out of her own handspun yarn, and the colorway that she dyed was just really, really beautiful. A gingery, caramelly color. It was really, really beautiful. So congratulations, Laura, and I am very looking forward to send this yarn to you. Please get in touch with me and send me your address. And then I have a third prize, which is going to someone, and this is the wonderful plant-dyed sock yarn from Wild About Yarn from Australia. And this colorway is called Weddell Garden, and it was dyed with Australian Weddell flowers and leaves and avocado skins. And I think random.org knows sometimes, because the person who wins this skein has entered a project of plant dyed sock yarn into our knit along. And this was post number 27, and the Ravelry user Mini Fishy Knit from France. And I think her name is Adeline, if I understood that correctly. It was not officially written on Ravelry, but she has a blog with something about Adeline. So congratulations, Adeline. You win this wonderful sock yarn, and you have knit this lovely pair of plant-dyed socks for our Cal, which also was, I think, dyed with avocados. And this makes me quite sure that you will enjoy this game. So congratulations to all three winners, and thank you very much for your participation in the Cal. And for all those of you who are sad that you didn't win the giveaway, there is a new chance to win some beautiful yarn right now. Because I would like to celebrate that we reached the 20th episode of the podcast, and also that we have now, I think, way more than 5,000 subscribers on YouTube. This is just insane. Thank you all so much, and welcome to those of you who are new to the channel, and I'm very happy that you are here and you are making my knitting life and crafting life so much richer since you are around through the podcast. So thank you very much. And in order to say thank you, I have a wonderful set of yarns for you, and this has been donated by Miss Farfelu. Look at these skeins. I think they come across very well in that light. We have here this speckled colorway, and this is called Lush, and I think it is a good name for it. It's so lush. There are so many different colors in it. So this one and this wonderful berry colorway were donated by Miss Farfelu, and she has an Etsy shop. And now I have to talk a little bit about this base, because this is, my friends, Eco Superwash Sock Yarn. So this has been treated with this ecologically friendly superwash process. And so you can make socks out of it if you want and wash them in the machine. But the superwash treatment was done in an environmentally friendly way with this alternative process. I don't know if it's the EXP process or not. So Miss Farfelu has an Etsy shop and she is in Canada. And I will put her information in the show notes. This here is her lovely little card. And Dominique from Miss Farfelu, she has spoiled me incredibly because she also sent two skeins for me. And she knows me. She picked these gorgeous colorways for me. And they are called Rabbit Hole. And this is just the most gorgeous green. I think it comes across a bit more brown on the camera than it actually is. It is very khaki, but a bit in a cool way, not in such a brown, warm way. It is really, really beautiful and has green and khaki and a bit of, I think, taupe. It is a very cool brown. It's very nice. And this is 200 grams and it's also the Eco Superwash sock yarn and it's organic merino. Also these guys basically are organic merino wool. And yeah, I think I'm gonna make a garment for me out of this. So thank you so much, Dominique, for sending these treasures my way and for this wonderful yarn that I can knit something for myself out of and that I will love to knit something for myself because it's just absolutely my colors and I will love to wear them. So in order to win these two lovely skeins of yarn, I would like you to find the Ravelry thread and for the giveaway and post there what you are going to make of this. Maybe socks, maybe brioche. It is absolutely next to skin soft. It could absolutely be a shawl, like a two-color shawl. Maybe you're going to pair it with something else that you have. Let me know what you're going to make of this, and I will pick a winner for this giveaway before the next podcast episode, and we'll announce the winner on the next podcast. So that was it for today. Thank you very much for joining. I hope you have enjoyed the little extra segment and I hope you're having a lovely spring or fall, wherever on the world you are. And happy knitting! See you next time! So that makes me quite sure that you are going to enjoy this game. Oh my god, it almost fell into my water glass.